apologize for everything.
Yeah, what's up? It's your boy Joe with my co-host
H. Jones, who apparently should be stabbed in the thigh.
No, I wasn't talking about you. I was just saying
somebody.
People in general.
All of them.
Anyways, but we're here. We're going to be doing another Mix It Up reaction with it's not a first time reaction because we both have heard this band at separate points in time. We tried to find a video for it, just didn't work. So we're just going to listen to the song because we both want to jam the song. We want to play. We talked about it in another video, and now it's we want to hear it. You know that feeling where you're like, remember that band, blah, blah, blah? Yeah, let's listen to one of theirs. Like, that's just what happened.
Yeah.
Be sure to like and subscribe and hit that bell notification to make sure you know when new videos are coming out. Be sure to like and comment, whatever you feel like doing. If you want, apexenergydrink.com has got a new hoodie for sale. Legends Never Die hoodie. Mm-hmm. Go ahead and check that out.
Let me get the other one.
No, don't worry about it. And then, of course, there's like a bottle cap opener. It says noob bottle opener.
He messed up the first recording, so I thought we were going to...
I kicked the camera.
Get it. I'm getting it.
I'm special.
Okay, so we're going to go ahead and check out Sick Puppies, Pitiful. Now, I know you're what you're thinking. Is this a foreign band? It is, but not really. They actually play quite a bit. Now, this singer with this band, I think, is named Simon, and it's the one that they originally the band was formed with. At least I think so. I don't know. Some guy could come in the comments and go, actually, they've had 17 other singers from the beginning. They started in 1932. But, no, which it's kind of funny though. Now the lead singer of the band, or at least from the last time I checked, the lead singer of the band is actually somebody I met many times because we played shows together. He was in a band called Glass Intrepid. I was in a band called Insider, and I was in other bands that we played shows with him too. But really good guy, down to earth guy. He's now the lead singer of Sick Puppies. So very cool to have a Houston. Local music artist who's now the lead singer of a band that tours the world. So you might want to check out their new stuff. We'll have the link below and everything. So check it out. Be sure to. And we'll, of course, review some of them or react to some of the songs and whatnot that we find videos for. But we just wanted to really play this song because we enjoy it. And if you haven't heard of Sick Puppies, you should check them out. They're pretty dope. Let's play
Pitiful.
It.
Pitiful.
Made the toast. It's so low.
No.
It's the YouTube video. Calm down.
Oh no, because it reset earlier.
Oh yeah. Yeah. You're right.
That gave me credit.
What? Got the bus, forgot the change. Looks like I'll be late again. Hopefully.
That always jams. Sing, they get mad.
Sorry. I'm gonna have to jam this on the way home. I have not heard this in a long time.
When did it come out? Like 2007 or 8?
It had to be college days.
2007 or 8, something like that.
Went to work, saw you there, but you seem to care for a single thing I say.
Can I hum?
Believe me, I even did that and they got mad. I mean, I don't mind. I'll do what I want when I want.
I do what I want.
But at the same time, I actually watched the video. I was like, oh, she's right. Yeah, that is annoying. Part is why Anna and I'm in love with her. That bass line's beautiful.
But
It's almost like riding a bike. Like, I haven't heard that song in probably 15 years.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like,
good decade plus for sure.
Just because, you know, stuff comes out all the time. So you jam it, you listen to it, and you move on occasionally. But when streaming started becoming like, because we've had streaming for a while, but streaming became like just why the heck are you going to buy an album? Just play it on stream. You know, that's been the past 10 years that has come to more fruition. And since it has, honestly, at that point, I realized I wasn't listening to older stuff, like, at all.
Yeah, it's all the new stuff.
It was just whatever new stuff came on, and occasionally I'd be like, a 90s channel or a 2000 OOs channel. And most of the time you hit those OOs channel, it's always like, oh, it's like pop punk, alternative punk. It's not some band from, I'm not going to even say it, I'm not going to say where they're from, because I've been wrong before.
It's okay.
It's somewhere around the Australian-New Zealand borders. Somewhere around there. I know they've played in Auckland. I know they've played in Sydney. I know they've... I'm not going to say anything more.
I'm over there.
There's... it. Yeah, okay. So for a while, a lot of people miss... Not a lot of people. It's just me. I mistake people from different countries. I can't help it. I don't remember things. It sucks. It's random what I do remember. Oh man, I hate having my memory.
But I didn't realize he had an accent. But when we were trying to find videos earlier, pulling up the live ones,
yeah.
Didn't realize that.
Yeah. Yeah. I don't know. It was very weird when I found out that Brian was actually a new lead singer for Sick Puppies. I was like, wait, what? Because honestly, I knew that they were very popular here too. Because of Pitiful and Dressed Up as Life and all that stuff. That was a great album. Mm-hmm. But, or Dressed as Life, or was Dressed Up as Life?
Dressed Up as Life.
Oh, anyways. But it was a great album. And a three-piece band to sound like that is impressive, you know? Because believe me, I've heard many three-piece bands. And only Tippy Top sound good, you know, other than like jazz trios and stuff like that. Yeah. But yeah, no, when he became lead singer, I was like, dude, that's awesome. That's pretty cool. I mean, I didn't talk to him or anything because he was busy being lead singer of a new band and touring the world and recording a bunch of stuff. Actually, I don't think I've talked to him in a very long time. Like, it's been years, maybe a decade.
Horrible friend?
No, we weren't friends. We were acquaintances.
Oh,
yeah, that's different. No, he was friends with my friends. I'm not going to say names or anything because I don't want people being creepy.
I heard anyway. You know Joe.
Yeah. But we're going to review one of their newer songs in the next couple weeks. We're on a little rock tear right now. Then we're going to be on a BTS tear. And then we're going to be on a Doja Cat, Ash Nico, Tom McDonald.
Who?
Oh, you. Oh, when I show you. He's an independent artist. Do not look him up after we're done with this. He's an independent artist. But it's gonna be a fun ride. I don't know what you're gonna think or feel. Right. It's gonna be a little bit weird.
Well, that I expect.
A little bit uncomfortable.
I expect that too.
He's a rapper.
Didn't think that was coming next. Nope.
He's a rapper. He's a hip hop artist, but he's completely independent. When I mean completely independent, I mean he pays and makes the videos. He pays and makes his albums. He produces them, all of it. He has a distribution that he goes through, but that is all. Everything he does, pretty much, and a lot of it, he ships himself out too. Like, he does everything independent, and he has multi-millions of views. Like, multi-millions of views, and has sold a lot of albums.
Okay.
And it's just because of YouTube and YouTube controversy.
Yeah.
And good marketing. Yeah, we're going to have fun with that one. Anyway, so, yeah, Sick Puppies, it's hard to really talk about it because we both like it. And I think I introduced them to you.
Yeah, you definitely did.
A long time ago when we were
doing graphics. When we were friends back then.
When we were friends. Oh, sinner. But, no, yeah, he used to pay me to do graphics for his band and groups and all. Then he started doing them because I taught him.
Yep, learned from the best.
Which is... dumb on my part.
No, it's not. No, it's
all
not.
It does is take money away from me.
No. Hey, it's the reason I eat.
No, I know. So just the reason okay. You eat?
Yeah.
Reason oh, I eat. Oh, yeah. Work. Yeah. I'm an idiot.
Yeah. Yes, okay. That too.
True. Thank you.
Oh, look, you hit the buttons.
Yeah, huh. I, you know what? I bought it because it had that, and I have yet to really use it.
Yeah, remember when you took them away from me?
I took it away from you because you were using it too much.
No.
I mean, I heard a cricket every other 10 and a half seconds because you thought it was funny to annoy me. That's why you don't get to touch the fucking buttons.
Let's ask the people.
Should no.
H. Jones get a chance to get the buttons again?
I don't care what the people say.
I care what you think. I don't care what he thinks.
Oh, you're a shit human.
I mean, you said what you said, so, you know, whatever.
I don't care what they think when it comes to you touching buttons.
But that's what everybody wants to
hear. You know
hear.
What? I'm going to make a little panel, and I'm going to Sharpie some buttons on it.
Oh,
put
yeah.
some squitchy stuff, and you can just sit there and press them all day long.
Oh, yeah. Like I'm 2 years old.
Yay.
Maybe I'll put, like, some weird sounds or something. Like, just something dumb. I don't know. I just don't want to give you something that you're going to annoy me with. That's the only problem, is I have this fear that you're going to be like, yeah, Joe, you gave me the buttons now.
I feel that with my kids. So.
Huh?
I feel that way with my kids. And be like, hey, can we get this toy? I'm like, it makes a lot of noise. It's got batteries. It's loud. You're going to drive me crazy. No.
Oh, yeah.
I get that.
I got a family story. Okay, so my aunt used to buy me every birthday or Christmas or birthday, I think it was. She'd buy me a Transformer. And this was when they were like die-cast metal and expensive. And I loved it. It was like, that woman... Like, that's the feeling I got as a kid was like, you get me. Like, that's what it was. Because my parents wouldn't know. They'd be like, what toy do you like? This? Like, that's what it was. But Aunt Mary was like, you want another Transformer? I got your Transformer. You want to check it out? Here's your happy birthday, blah, blah. And I'd get it. I'd be like, oh, this is so awesome. Well, she got one time that my mom immediately went, ah. Like, she was not happy about. And it was I can't remember the Decepticon. It was the purple one. And it was die-cast metal. His legs were janky because it was supposed to be he could turn into a gun, like a ray gun.
Yeah.
And his legs were, like, right next to each other and they swiveled like that because it was supposed to go click, shoop, and it'd be the handle. So that's what his legs were. So that you really couldn't stand this thing at all. You know, it'd look all weeble-wobble. And, put a 9-volt battery in that thing and it would make these crazy noises and lights. And she just looked at my camera. Thanks for that. Mm-hmm. He's going to never stop doing it.
Mm-hmm. Just she wait even for told me batteries to die.
She told me that it went to sleep one time. She told me that, they don't make 9-volt batteries anymore. Like stuff like that. Like my mother was very talented at just bending the truth a little bit to be like, for my own sanity and not beating you to death with that, I'm going to say this. Yeah. I love that toy too. I broke the tar out of it though, because the legs were all janky. I kept trying to stand gun. Yeah. But,
we'll find you one on Amazon.
Huh?
We'll find you one on Amazon.
I don't think you can.
Amazon has everything.
I'm pretty sure those die-cast toys were lead-based. I'm fairly sure, man, because that was the 80s, and the 80s was like, children have small hands to build toys in China. Like, that's what it was. Pretty sure those were all lead-based and then, like, covered in chrome to look like shiny metal because it was always, like, black metal underneath it. Yeah, but, yeah, man, so that was Sick Puppies, Pitiful. Don't really know if we even talked about the song after it was done, but it's okay because we both like it. Well, that's not point. Of course, we end up liking a lot of stuff, but I love their dynamics and the way they write and their arrangements.
And the bass player.
And the bass player.